Gloomsbury, a rhapsody about bohemians by Sue Lim. Episode 1, The Trials of Attempting an Elopement. It is the autumn of 1922, give or take a year or two, and in the garden of Sizzlinghurst Castle in Kent, the colourful writer Vera Sackcloth Vest is contemplating her north border.
Gosling? Gosling?
Yes, madam?
Where on earth are you? I can't see a thing in this fog.
Over here.
Oh, I thought you were the Vestal Virgin.
Beg pardon, madam?
You know, the lead statue of the Vestal Virgin, the Roman girl.
She's further down. I got a letter for you, madam, from your husband.
Don't call me madam. Remember what I said.
Sorry, sir.
That's better. Now, I'll just read this.
My darling Vera, I'm writing this on the sofa, where I've been since that wonderful lunch we shared. I miss you dreadfully, my darling. It's torment. Where are you? In the walled garden? The potager? Digging the new border? Hurry back, for goodness sake, dearest. This separation is unendurable. Ever your devoted, Henry.
Poor darling Henry. I'll just dash him off a quick note. Dearest Henry, you're right. This separation is too terribly cruel. It's madness. I shall come back indoors and be reunited with you the moment I've finished instructing Gosling, your adoring Vera. Take this to him, Gosling, but first I just wanted a word with you. I'm going away for a few weeks, and while I'm gone, I want you to replant this north border. Let's have 667 acanthus bolognese along the back, mixed with about 199 formaggio mezzaluna, and perhaps just a judicious smattering of pericoloso sporghese at the front.
Would that be the pink pericoloso or the cream, sir?
Cream, of course, man. I won't have pink anywhere at Sizzlinghurst. If I'm strolling along the North Walk next summer and I see the merest hint of pink, I'll beat you to a pulp.
Thank you, sir. I'll look forward to that.
Ah, I think I can smell euonymus.
That'll be my cologne, sir. West Indian lime.
I didn't know you aspired to cologne, Gosling. I suppose that firebrand Ramsay MacDonald has put ideas into your head. Now, I want to discuss my fuchsias.
I just wanted to say, sir, as I've always admired the way you and the master lives your lives.
Thank you, Gosling. Now, I want you to mulch my fuchsias. We could have a severe frost any time now.
When you say you're going away for a while, will that be with one of your lady friends?
Don't be impertinent, man.
Only, I just wanted to say is how I admires the way you elopes with your lady friends from time to time. And the master elopes with his men friends, and it's neither here nor there. If you get my drift.
My husband does not, as you so colourfully put it, elope with his men friends. He has to go abroad frequently to do important work for the Foreign Office.
No offence intended, sir. I only wanted to say how much I admires your carrying on. And how much I wish it was available to the likes of me.
Thank you, Gosling. But I would ask you never to address me on this matter again.
Right you are, sir.
Now, don't forget, before you plant anything, dig in at least 7 wagon loads of fresh manure. Horse, pig, cattle, the prep school down the road.
The vicarage, sir?
Yes, the vicarage, of course. But first, just nip indoors and deliver my letter to my husband. Tell him I'll be with him just as soon as I've tied up Mrs. Herbert Stevens. I don't want her thrashing about in a gale.
You left me sad and lonely. Why did you leave me lonely? Cause here's a heart that's only for
Henry.
Hello, Vera, darling, at last. I was beginning to worry. Oh,
sorry it took me so long. I had the dickens of a job getting through to Gosling. He seems to have taken leave of his senses, banging on about how much he admires our bohemian lifestyle.
Well, it can't be much fun cuddling up to Mrs. Gosling every night. What a dragon.
Oh, you're not still reading that damn newspaper.
Frightful trash, I know, but I'm hoping there'll be a happy ending.
Thank you so much for your wonderful letter, darling.
And thank you for yours. It was perfection. I think I'd set it to music if I wasn't tone deaf.
Perhaps I'll ask Venus to set it to music when I next see her.
Oh, there was a letter from her. Here, what's it say?
Vera, my angel, Have pity on me. I'm stuck in darkest Devon in a cold, clammy cottage, all on my own, with a smoking fire and absolutely no servants. Every night I sob myself to sleep. Come and rescue me, darling. Ever, your devoted Venus.
She says she's stuck in a clammy cottage in Devon, all on her own.
I expect that means she's whooping it up in a massive mansion with a house party of 33.
Now, don't be too hard on her, darling. It must be awful being married to Derek. He's a dry old stick, and a stuffed shirt, and a cold fish.
Sounds like a weekend I spent fishing in Ireland once. Anyway, I think poor old Derek must have a hard time of it being married to Venus. I know how fond you are of her, but honestly...
Oh, do stop whinging, darling. Forget about silly old Venus. So, what's in the paper? Anyone we know getting divorced?
Only the Archon of Swat.
How tiresome of him, such a show-off. Now, is there any tea?
It's gone cold. I was dipping my Garibaldi in it, and I'm afraid a bit dropped off.
Darling, you're such a messy little trollop. I'll ring for some more. So, nothing in the papers, then?
There's unrest in Ouagadougou, a riot in Rio, a drought in Droida, and an epidemic in Epidaurus.
How upsetting. Is there no good news?
There's a delightful photo of the new world bantamweight champion, Eddie Cannonball Martin. Look at his petrels.
He's terribly Michelangelo, isn't he? Why don't you invite him down for the weekend? You could take photographs of him, wearing a range of ragged singlets.
I can't say I'm not tempted.
You rang, sir?
Yes, more tea, please, Mrs. Gosling. Darjeeling for you, Henry?
Please, and some cucumber sandwiches with all the dear little crusts cut off. And the skin cut off the cucumbers, too, if it's not too much trouble.
Oh, no, madam, no trouble at all.
You shouldn't cut the skin off cucumbers, Henry. It'll make you burp like bilio.
I'll do what I want with cucumbers in my own house, darling.
Well, I'll have a mug of British workman's tea, Mrs. Gosling, and make sure the mug's cracked.
Very well, sir.
And I'll have a buttered crumpet. No, make that 7.
Will that be all, sir?
For the present, yes.
One more thing, sir. There's a beggar at the door with no arms or legs.
Really? Give him a buttered crumpet and tell him to think about joining a circus.
Very well, sir. Oh, I forgot. There's a letter for you from Mrs. Fox.
From Ginny? How divine. Thank you.
Dearest Vera, I'm lying down with a truly epic headache. The fog rubs itself up against the window panes, reminding me of you. The clock strikes 10 with a deep, slightly melancholy baritone, reminding me of you. For the past 2 days, I've been staring at a crack on the ceiling, which more than anything reminds me of you. Lionel is very kind, bringing me cups of chamomile tea, but he lacks your smouldering amber eyes and feline grace. This is a note just to let you know I am still clinging to life and to beg you not to come and see me. I am too dreadfully moribund for words. If by chance we should never meet again, you can have my manuscript of Borlando. Sleep with it under your pillow, dearest, and remember me.
How is she?
Absolutely fine. But listen, Henry, don't be cross.
When am I ever cross with you, darling?
Wait till you hear what I have to say. I want to elope.
But, darling, you eloped with Lady Sylvia Architrave only 4 months ago.
That wasn't a real elopement, darling. She was such a bore. No conversation.
How frightful.
Yes. I'm going to ask Ginny this time.
Is she in a fit state to elope?
I'll soon prize her off her damn sofa. November in London, Henry. It's too ghastly for words.
What about the boys?
What boys?
Charlie and Fred.
Who? The boys. Where are the boys? I haven't seen them for days.
Away at school.
Where was that again?
Eton.
Oh, yes, how charming. I think I had a letter from Charlie last week asking for a pea shooter. He must think I'm made of money. I must say, Lionel, that cassoulet was first rate.
I do have a weakness for duck's legs.
Oh, absolutely. I have a weakness for any sort of legs. Such a shame we can't take some up to Ginny.
No, she simply can't face food when she has one of her headaches.
How long has she been like this?
Oh, about 2 weeks. The really awful thing is she can't write.
Can't she? I can't stop writing.
I know. We all admire your energy, Vera.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.